Gonya Mabagiti Baba.
In South Africa, there's the good, the bad, and the ugly. Now what you see here are the townships Gugulethu and Cape Town, South Africa. These townships go on for miles around South Africa. About 87% of the population who live in the townships are HIV infected. The government of South Africa is trying to move them out because they're not authorized to live there. But the people do not want to leave because first, they are very comfortable, and second, they have no place to go. The image you see here is a student carrying a young boy by the name of Hector Peterson. On June 16, 1976, Hector Peterson was the first student to be shot and killed during the Soweto riots by a Dutch police officer. He was only 13 years old at the time. The reasoning of his death was because him and thousands of other high school students from the ages of 13 to 19 marched because they did not want to be taught an unpopular language brought from the Dutch called Afrikaans. In memory of Hector Peterson and those who died for the fight towards freedom and democracy, the Hector Peterson Museum was built. There are about 3 million orphans in South Africa. Over half is infected with HIV and AIDS. But then there are the lucky ones, who do have a family, but are still infected with HIV and or AIDS. For example, my family went to visit a widow who lost a husband to HIV and died in 2006. She is now left with 3 children who are all HIV positive. She is lucky to live in a tin shack from what she used to live in, which was a straw hut. And then there's Lerato. Lerato is a 6-year-old girl living in Lesotho, Southern Africa. I sponsor her and raise money for her from my party. And there's me at Cape of Good Hope, the most southwestern point of the African continent. Oh, and check out Barak Street.
Near the village, the peaceful village, the lion sleeps tonight. Near the village, the quiet village, the lion sleeps tonight.
Yes, South Africa does have penguins. They have the most penguins in the world. Now this is Robben Island. This was the prison for the political leaders who fought against apartheid in South Africa. Nelson Mandela spent his remaining 18 years out of his 27 years in this prison. Although being prisoners were bad enough, there was even segregation within the jails. Anyone who was of a different color or black would get better treatment, including more food and actual beds to sleep on. If you were colored, you would have much more food and sleep on a bed. If you were black, you would sleep on a mattress like this. And this was Nelson Mandela's cell. He was isolated by himself with no one to talk to. This would make a man crazy, but it only made Mr. Mandela stronger. This is also the cell where he wrote his famous book, Long Walk to Freedom. At first, prisoners were not allowed to be educated while on Robben Island. but the men found a way to educate one another in this cave in the limestone fields that they would work on. Season over. On the last day of my trip, I visited an HIV and AIDS organization I also benefited to from my birthday party, called Monkey Biz. Monkey Biz is an HIV and AIDS organization where men and women who are infected with HIV and AIDS create beaded dolls and other items to help support their families, their health care, and sometimes the money may go towards the funeral of a family member who has died from HIV and AIDS. I raised about $2,500 for this group, and this was when I was presenting them with the money. This was truly an amazing trip. I met new friends. Saw the fantastic scenery. And most importantly, had a blast with my family. Most people do not know how fortunate they are to be living here in the United States. Just remember to appreciate the little things you have, because many around the world would love to have just a tiny bit of the advantages we have here in the USA.
So now how do you feel being here at Monkey Biz?
I feel great. I mean, at first I just heard about Monkey Biz. I never really witnessed what they did, but like now seeing the actual work they've done and the piece that they made, Lakers, my favorite team in the world. And so I'm just happy to be here, excited to meet all these people. And Cape Town is my new home.
Me too.